So in this video, I'm going to do a comparison of four magnetic loops. Now, magnetic loops have become really popular for HF reception. Three of these do work from or up to 30 megahertz, where one of them does go up to 200 megahertz, but more on that shortly. The four loops that I have, three of these I own. The MLA30, a cheap Chinese loop, costs between 30 and 40 pounds here in the UK. Off the likes such of eBay. I have modified this. I've removed the really poor coax that it comes with and fitted a BNC to the unit. Now, the next loop I have is the Cross Country Wireless. Now, this is a new loop that's just been recently released and is about 60, 70 pounds. I have been lent the Bonito ML200. So thank you, Mike. That's Mike Ladd of the SDR Play technical team, has sent me this just for the purposes of this video to do the comparison. Now, the Bonito has been replaced by the Megaloop FX, and by all accounts, that is better in performance than the ML200. The other loop that I'm going to be using is the Wellbrook 1530LN. Now, the LN will be used with its aluminium loop that it came with. The other three loops are going to be used with a 5 meter wire loop. The coax length are all the same, they're in the same area, so we're trying to keep the testing as equal as possible. I am using SDR Uno, as can be seen from the screen, and I'm also using the RSP Duo by SDR Play, which is a dual tuner single device. The reason I'm using that is that I can keep, I can use a single device for the testing so that I can keep everything, as I say, as equal as possible. On the right hand screen, well, I have the Wellbrook 1530LN, and that one will be the constant that we're going to compare all the others against to give us a reference point. First of all, I have the CCW Cross Country Wireless loop. It's on the left-hand screen. I'm going to be using the broadcast bands to do the comparisons as we just go up and down those. I have set the AGC to off and set them both at 20 dB, which will be the same for all the loops. Sorry, get the right screen. So, and the reason I've set that low is to try and negate any of the overload that can occur on HF. So, as we can see straight off, we're on 75 meters, that the noise floor on the Wellbrook is lower than the Cross Country Wireless, and it, on the SNR, is also better on the Wellbrook. We are comparing a £60 loop with a £300 loop, so there is a significant cost difference. So as we go up on 60 meters, again, the noise floor on both is pretty similar, but the Wellbrook is performing better, as should be really expected. On 49, they're quite comparable. 41. Again, very similar. On 31. On 31, I would say that the Wellbrook is doing better and is handling noise better. On 25. We can clearly see we are pulling more signals out with the Wellbrook. 19 and long wave. And medium wave. We can clearly see that we are getting some overloading with the Cross Country, but even so, we can see the massive difference in the noise floor on that one. So we have now swapped over to the ML A30, the cheap Chinese loop, and even though the noise floor is higher, it's actually performing very, very well on 75 meters. On 60, again, the noise floor is higher, but we're still getting good signals. On 49, still pretty good. Not as good as the Wellbrook, but still very good. Now the MLA30 is actually performing very well in comparison. Now, when I use the MLA30 with the little wallet that come with it, the lower bands were quite poor on it. Since we've extended the length of the loop, that's actually quite helped with that. And the way this is comparing to the Wellbrook, it's 10 times the price the Wellbrook is in comparison to the MLA30. It's a very, very good for the price. It works extremely well and seems to be performing better than the cross-country wireless. So finally, we have the Bonito ML200 on the left-hand screen against the Wellbrook on the right. Now, as we can see, the noise floor on the Bonito is better and it is pulling the signals better. Now, the Bonito and the Wellbrook are very similar in price, but the Bonito definitely seems to have the edge. And if the FX does outperform the ML200, that is definitely a loop that I would consider buying, and I'd love to try one just to see how much better it is. And one thing that the Bonito can do that the other three can't: the other three are rated up to 30 megahertz, so covering the whole HF band. The Bonito goes up to 200 megahertz, so that covers the civil air band as well. And the FX, I believe, goes up to 180 megahertz. So if I tune to my local ATIS, now my local airfield is about 15 miles away in a straight line. The loop is about 6 foot off the floor. So the fact that it is actually pulling in my local ATIS on 122.675 very well. And one other thing I noticed when testing the Bonito, having a play with it, it does work very well up into the business bands. Even though it's not rated to go that high, we have found that it actually pulls in signals very well up there. So for an all-in-one antenna, the Bonito definitely would be a good choice. One thing, as we sort of draw to a conclusion, the Bonito for me does have the edge. The Wellbrook is very comparable, but not quite as good as the Bonito. Both of these would be very good choices if funds allowed. The third one that comes in third and very close to the Wellbrook is the MLA30, which is a bit of a surprise. Not as good as the Wellbrook, but it is 10 times cheaper. And lastly, the cross-country wireless has come in last place, but when you compare the MLA30 components to the cross-country wireless components, the build quality of the cross-country wireless is better. All four of these loops will run off a bias T, off an SDR, such as the RSPs. So that would be a very difficult choice between these two, and both are good loops. For me, I think the Bonito would be my preferred choice, and as I don't own one of these yet, I'm going to be quite disappointed that I've actually got to send it back. But I will be looking at the FX. Hope you've enjoyed watching, and you can draw your own conclusions from the video.